Find the limit of x squared over 1 minus cosine x as x approaches 0. So when you have a limit, the first thing you should try to do is evaluate it at the number. So if we plug in 0, we get 0 squared over 1 minus the cosine of 0. So this is equal to 0 over 1 minus, and cosine of 0 is 1, so we get 1 minus 1. So we get 0 over 0. So we have what's called an indeterminate form. So whenever we have a form that's 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity, we can use something called L'Hopital's rule. So L'Hopital's rule says that whenever we have one of these two forms, in this case we have 0 over 0, we can just take the derivative of the top and the derivative of the bottom. So the derivative of the top piece is 2x. Okay, and on the bottom, well, the derivative of 1 is 0. The derivative of cosine is negative sine, but there's already a negative here, so it's just going to become a positive sine. Oh, this is interesting, because if we plug in 0 again, we end up with 2 times 0 over sine of 0. So we end up with 0 over 0, so it happened again, right? So we still have an indeterminate form, 0 over 0. So now what we can do is we can use L'Hopital's again. So this is the limit as x approaches 0. The derivative of 2x is 2, and the derivative of sine x is cosine x. And now we're in a good place, right? Now we can plug in 0, and we get 2 over cosine of 0. Cosine of 0 is 1, so it's 2 over 1. And so the answer is just 2. So kind of a cool problem. We ended up using L'Hopital's rule, and then we got here, and then we had to use it again. So kind of an interesting question. So I hope this video has been helpful. That's it.